Have you noticed ads becoming more and more personal? Wondering how Amazon knows exactly what you are looking for before you do? Or maybe you want to understand how publishers make money? The answer is AdTech and MarTech, and you are already a user. In this video, we will define AdTech and MarTech, go over the differences between the two, give an overview of how programmatic advertising works, and dive into where Google, Amazon, Facebook, and Apple fit into this landscape. So what are AdTech and MarTech? AdTech, as you may have guessed, is short for advertising technology, and MarTech is short for marketing technology. Seems simple, right? Well, AdTech and MarTech include a huge range of solutions you already use, solutions from companies like Google, Amazon, Facebook, and Apple. So every time you get a camping ad after you search for camping on Google, that's ad tech. Or when your Amazon suggested items are a little too personal, that's MarTech. So what is the difference between ad tech and MarTech? MarTech includes solutions for all forms of marketing, things like content calendars, AI content writers, data management, and more. Ad tech, on the other hand, primarily focuses on paid channels. These include most of the places you see advertising, such as social media ads, search ads, email ads, and more. Programmatic advertising. How does programmatic advertising work? If you think about the ads you see, two sides become clear. The advertisers, otherwise known as the buy side, and the publishers, called the sell side. The advertisers include brands like Nike, Columbia, and McDonald's. These are companies that have the demand for high-quality, brand-safe places to run their ads. Publishers are on the other side. These are media companies and platforms that supply the audience and the inventory of this brand-safe ad space. Companies like BuzzFeed and Forbes. So the advertisers make up the demand side, and the publishers are the supply side. In the middle, we have the ad exchange. The ad exchange functions as an auction house, allowing this exchange to take place between the two sides. First, the supply side will leverage a tool called a supply side platform, or an SSP, to connect and sell their ad space on the ad exchange. And the demand side will use a tool called a DSP, or a demand side platform, to place a bid on that ad space. Anywhere from a few to hundreds of companies can bid for the same ad slots. And this all happens in real time, which is where the name RTB, or real-time bidding, comes from. The ad space goes to the winning bid, and that is what you see when the page loads. This auction happens for each user, which is why ads have become more and more personal. This allows the advertiser to show their ads to the audience they want, and the publisher to get paid the best amount for their ad space. Walled gardens. You might be wondering how Google, Amazon, and Facebook fit into this landscape. These are walled gardens, meaning you can only buy their inventory or supply using their first-party tools, like Google Ads, Facebook Business Manager, or Amazon Advertising. In fact, Facebook, Amazon, and Google account for 64.4% of the digital ad revenue. These components make up the majority of the digital advertising landscape. There are other players, but we will dive into them in another video. A career in ad tech and MarTech means building a data-first skill set, helping to keep the internet free to use, and enabling businesses to connect to their customers. All while working in a fast-paced, global environment. Want to learn more? Message us now to find out what positions are open in AdTech and MarTech. I'm looking forward to speaking with you, Wahl+Case.